Between Mars and Jupiter, there is a large void, an area to study that astronomers enjoy. A gap with a ring made up of millions of planetoids, or also known as a belt of asteroids. Hurtling through space in their orbit round the sun, these large irregularly shaped rocks have a lot of fun. Made up of different rocks and metals, each asteroid is unique. Let's go out and find some and see who we can meet. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet the four largest known asteroids.
My name is Ceres, the largest asteroid to be discovered. But now I'm classified as a dwarf planet. My true self has been uncovered. I'm the largest known object in the asteroid belt, it's true. I have a thin atmosphere that could contain water vapor from my surface, too.
My name is VESTA, one of the four largest asteroids known. I have a unique surface like that of terrestrial worlds long ago. My surface used to be very active and was covered in lava flows. I have a huge impact crater so deep that my inner mantle is exposed.
My name is PALLAS, the second asteroid discovered after Ceres. I have an eccentric inclined orbit. I like to orbit differently.
I'm the asteroid Hygieia, but scientists discovered that I'm round, which means I finally qualify, and I'm a dwarf planet candidate now!
Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. A collision with one is something Earth should avoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet some more asteroids.
I'm Ida. I'm special because I have a friend at my side. His name is Dactyl, my moon, and he's only about a mile wide. We travel in the asteroid belt together. It's good to have a friend beside me. There are hundreds of other asteroids that have moons or are binary.
I'm Venu. I don't live in the asteroid belt. I orbit between Earth and Mars. I'm known as a near-Earth asteroid because from Earth, I'm not that far. NASA's OSIRIS-REx visited me in 2018 and made a discovery. I shoot out plumes of dust that create a haze around me.
I'm Itokawa, and I'm a near-Earth asteroid, too. I might collide with Earth someday, but we've got about a million years before I do. I'm the first asteroid from which actual samples were taken from me. Now they're back on Earth for scientists to study.
Asteroids range in size from really large to really small. But if you measured the mass of each asteroid and added up them all, the entire mass of all the asteroids in the asteroid belt combined is less than the mass of our moon Luna. That totally blows my mind. Not all the asteroids in the solar system are in the asteroid belt. There are near-Earth asteroids inside the belt and other groups further out. Made up of different rocks and metals, each asteroid is unique. Let's go and find some more and see who else we meet. Let's go meet the asteroids. They're oddly shaped rocks. They're not spheroids. Careening through space in an expansive void. Most of them won't hit us, so don't be paranoid. Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go meet some more asteroids.
PATROCLUS and MENOETIUS, we're binary asteroids. We're not from the asteroid belt, but further out, Trojan asteroids. We share Jupiter's orbit in our journey around the sun. It's a much longer orbit than the asteroid belt, but together it's lots more fun.
Not from the asteroid belt or Trojans. I live beyond this. I'm a member of an asteroid class known as Centaurs between Saturn and Uranus. I'm also very unique because of a very special feature you see. I'm the first asteroid to be discovered with rings. I have two around me.
I'm near-Earth asteroid Apophis and will pass by Earth in 2029. But don't worry, I won't hit you. I just want to say hi.
Let's go meet the asteroids. Let's go and meet the asteroids.